Hello everyone. Yesterday I decided to pull out one of my sketches that I have been having in a closet for a while, and I did a little revamping to the sketch. It wasn't fully complete. I may have pictures of how it looked before I finally decided that I was happy with how it looks now. There's still things that I would like to change about it, but maybe I could change it during the painting process. But I would like to share some of this painting process with you all. So what I'm gonna do is finish getting my table set up. I have to drape the table. I'm going to add a layer of gesso on top of the painting. And then once the gesso dries, I'll add a layer of tone, and then I'll come back and be set up and ready to share the painting process with you. Okay guys, so I have the table draped and ready, and I also have I wanted to show you that I did mix up a thin layer of gesso here. It's a thin milky layer. Even though my canvas is pre-gessoed, I still like to add a thin layer of gesso to start building the canvas myself. And what I did was I mixed a little bit of this heavy body gesso. This is a thinner, more flowy gesso, and I added just a little water to it, and I have this nice milky layer, so that once I place it on the canvas, it'll stick, but my lines will still show through. I also wanted to share with you something that I mentioned in my previous video, my book haul video. I said that I would have an easier way to film for you guys, so here it goes. I have a ring light now, and this will be my first time using the ring light, so we'll see how this goes. So I think we are at a good angle to start filming. I had to take my phone case off to put my phone in the ring light because it was a little too wide with the case on. With this big bump at the back, the phone wouldn't lay flush, so I took the phone case off, put the phone inside the ring light, and I think we're at a good angle to start. So I have my coffee here, and my cup says, "I'm a Mimi, what's your superpower?" And speaking on that, I will officially be a Mimi of two in about a week and a half. I'll be heading to Louisiana because my daughter is having her second baby. I have a granddaughter already, and we are expecting a baby boy on August 10th. So I have my coffee ready here, and I'll be snacking on some of my favorite cookies, if you can see them here. So let's get started, guys. Hopefully I'm not in frame because I really don't like to be on the camera much. But if I am, I know where I have the phone angled, so I'm trying to stay out of the way. And I had to grab a new painting towel. I have painting towels, but since I have moved, I haven't completely gone through all of my art supplies to see where all of my things are. So I just want a thin layer of gesso. So guys, I am back and the gesso has dried, and as you can see, I can run my hand across the canvas and I have I'm not picking up any graphite. So this is how I like my canvas to be in order for me to begin working with it. So now I was kind of debating as to whether or not I was going to do the toning, but I just decided to go ahead on and do it. And I'm going to tone with this this Master's Touch burnt sienna, and it's gonna be acrylic. This is gonna be an acrylic painting, so I'm gonna go ahead on and begin toning with this. And again, it's gonna be a very thin layer. I'm gonna put some of the paint on here and add a little water to it and spread a thin layer of tone on top of the canvas. Okay guys, I am back and I think I'm gonna begin working on her sun hat. And I would like the sun hat to lean more toward a yellow ochre, but since I don't have a yellow ochre, I'm going to have to build my colors to try to get as close to it as I can. And I think I'm going to experiment with these three colors here. I have a light portrait pink by Master's Touch, a burnt sienna by Master's Touch, and I have a brilliant yellow by Liquitex. So I'm going to mix these three colors together to see what the outcome will be. Okay, guys, I have a nice clean palette and I'm ready to begin again. So, let's see. This is cobalt blue and ultramarine blue. So, I think I'm gonna go with an ultramarine blue. With the ultramarine blue and the Napathol red, because I want more of a magenta color for the bowl. So let's see what we can get. So I thought I'd save you the boredom of the actual color mixing. On this side, I have cobalt blue, Napathol red, and a little bit of the titanium white. And here on this side, it is the ultramarine blue, the Napathol red, and a little titanium white. So this is the colors that I will go with for the bowl, and let's get started on that.
So my daughter came out of her room to talk for a minute, so I just stopped filming, but I kept going with the painting, and this is where I am so far. I still have to add highlights to both the head and the bowl to bring out more details in it, but I think I'm gonna stop right here for tonight because I'm getting a little tired, and I will pick back up on it within the next few days. I work tomorrow, so within the next few days I'll pick up on it and go on with part two of the video. But I hope you enjoy what I shared so far, and until next time, thank you for watching.